Good morning, everyone. So class, today I will start here one more type of set, which is equal set, right? I hope in previous video you have covered all the points. Now let's start our first topic, equal set. As you can understand by this word equal, right? It means we will talk about here equality, right? So class, if given two set A and B, if we can say every element of A is also an element of B, then we can say what? That are equal. Both. If element of A should belongs to B set and element of B should belong to A, then we can say both are what? Equal set. If it's not exist, it means we can say it's a unequal set. And we have to represent equal by this symbol, A is equal to B, and unequal set by A, which is not equal to B. Right, class? Class, here I have some examples. First example I have here, let A is 1, 2, 3, 4. What? A is 1, 2, 3, 4. And B, which is 3, 1, 4, 2. As you can see, class, in both set we have same element. Here 1, 2, 3, 4. Here I have 3, 1, 4, 2. Order is different, but we have same element in B and A. So we can say A is equal to B. Right? Let's talk about second part. Let A be the set of prime numbers less than 6 and P the set of prime factors of 30. Then A and P are equal. Since 2, 3 and 5 are the only prime factors of 30. Also, these are less than 6. Right? If I will take here this set as A, right? Prime numbers less than 6, it means 2, 3, 5, right? 2, 3, 5. And here P with a set of prime factors of 30. P with a set of prime factors of what? 30. If I will take here prime factors of 30, what it will be, class? 2, 3, 5, 6 also, right? So here I have one more digit, which is 6, right? But here I have a condition, element will be less than 6. If 6 is a divisor of 30, right? So we don't have to take here 6. So elements will be 2, 3, 5, got it, class? So we can say A and B, both sets are equal. Let's take here one more example. Example number 7. Find the pair of equal set if any give reasons. Now we have given here so many set, and we have to, from these set we have to figure out which pair we can have here equal set. If it is equal, then well and good, we have to use A is equal to B, B is equal to C, like this. But we have to go with each pair, like A, B, A. With A I have to go with B, C, D, E. Like this, okay. If I will go with A first, you can see in solution, 0 belongs to A. In first set, I have only one element, 0. But you can see 0 we cannot see in any other set, B, C, D, E. How? See. As you can see, I have here x is greater than 15 and x is less than 5. Foundation we have 5 se chota hona chahiye, 15 se bada hona chahiye. It means I don't have here any single value, which is 0. Let's talk about here. If I will solve it here, a value of x will be 5, right? I don't have here value of 0. So if I will talk about here the value of x, it will be plus minus 5. Same again, I don't have here 0 element. If I will talk about this, x square minus 2x minus 15. For it, class, I have to find out it, right? After simplification, I can say about it, right? If I will figure out it, then I can have here the element 5. Right, after simplification, it means I don't have here value 0. So it means, class, A will not belong to B, A is not equal to B, A is not equal to C, A will not be equal to any set. Right? So this is all about what? Parity of equal sets. Now let's see what we have here. One more extra thing. Since B is not 5, but none of the other sets are empty. Look at here. Now I have to go with B, as I have gone here in first part A with all the set. Now I will go here with B. So as you can see in B, I have some elements. It's not empty set. I have definitely some counting numbers, some listed numbers under this set, right? X is less than 5, X is less than 5, and X is greater than 15, right? So it will be what? ऐसा पॉसिबल ही नहीं है. X 5 से भी छोटा हो और X 15 से बड़ा हो, राइट? सो दिस सेट विल बी क्लास 5, बट नन ऑफ अदर सेट्स आर एम्प्टी. X B सेट वी हैव हियर 5 एंड अदर सेट्स आर अदर वी हैव सम वैल्यूज, सो वी कैन नॉट से B विल बी इक्वल टू C, B विल बी इक्वल टू D, B विल बी इक्वल टू E आल्सो, राइट? लेट्स नाउ टॉक अबाउट C. I have to just figure out with C what we have in C. In C set class, you can see I have the value of X which is 5, right? I have the value of X which is 5. It means under C set I have value 5, one element I have. But you can see another element, I don't have 5 value in A, B is empty. If I will talk about D, in D I have one more value, right? So which is what? Plus minus, it's D is what? Plus minus 5. And here I have with positive number one more value, so I cannot say it is equal to D, right? So we have to write here C is not equal to D. Now let's talk about E. E is 5. After simplification, we can say we have here E which is 5, so we can say C will be equal to E. For the D, we can say we have element minus 5 and 5, and E we have 5 elements, so we can say D is not equal to E. Why we can say D is not equal to C? Try to understand this thing, class. In both set, we have common element which is 5, right? Definition of equality set is what? D ke elements E mein hone chahiye aur E ke elements D mein hone chahiye, right? This is the definition of equality. But you can see we have only one element of E. We have one element of D under E, right? So we cannot say it's equal to E. So only one pair we got after verification here, which is C and E. Now let's talk about here. One more example I have here, example number 8. In this example class, you can see we have to just figure out which pair of sets are equal. Which pair of sets are equal, and we have to justify our answer. I have here in first part X, the set of letters in alloy, and B, the set of letters in loyal. Remember this thing, I have to deal with only first part. Okay, in first part I have given two set, X and B. In X, if I will write this set as element in roster form, I can write it A-L-L-O-Y, right? And in B set, you can see I can write it L-O-Y-A-L. Then just figure out for the parity, equality, all the elements should be in X and all the elements should be in B, right? Is it possible? Just check out. Yes, I can see I have all the elements. I have here 2L, similarly I have here 2L in set B, right? If I will go with Y, in Y I have in X as well as in B I have. If I will go with O, in set B I have O, similarly in set X I have O. If I will go with A element, see, in both set I have same element, right? So we can say, In both set we have repetition of one element, which is L, right? So class, this is what we can say, X is equal to B, right? But when it is about representation, as I told you, no need to write L twice time. You know, no need to represent any element twice, right? You have to write single. As you can see, single element we have represented here. So this is all we can say here. We have a parity between X and B. Now let's talk about second example. In second element class, N belongs to Z. N belongs to what? Z, integer. And here N square is less than and equal to 4. N square is less than and equal to 4. And one more thing I have here. X belongs to R. And this equation I have here, x square minus 3x plus 2 is equal to 0. Got it? For find out the answer, is this pair equal or not, we have to first figure out what is the value of n I have in both, right? If I will solve this, n square is less than or equal to 4, what can I have here? I have to here replace n by, I have to take here all the values of z, right? If I will replace it by 0, 0 square, I will start here from 0, right? If I will replace n by 0, plus it will be less than or equal to 4. Yes, so this value will come in our set, right? If I will take here positive 1, square of 1, which is less than 4, yes, it's less than 4. So you can take it. See class, as we have square on n, right? If I will take negative n, then definitely it will be less than or equal to 4. So you can also write negative 1 in this set. If I will replace n by 2, right, what I got? 4, which is less than or equal to 4. So you can take it. Similarly, negative 2, right? If I replace n by 3, 3 square is 9, which is greater than 4. So it will not come under this set. And similarly, minus 3 also. So this counting numbers I have, this we can list it out in set A. Now let's talk about here B part. X square minus 3x plus 2. As you can see, this is what? This is quadratic equation. For this, you have to simplify it, and after simplification, we can have the value x, which will be class 1 and 2, which will be 1 and 2, right? The value of x will be 1 and 2, so we can represent it as a set B, which is 1 and 2. Now, point is what? We have to check out, are the sets are equal or not? In one set, we have 5 element, and second set, I have 2 element. Do root that B equal nahi hai, right? So just write down. No need to just write anything. Just write down A's and B both are not equal set. And this is the symbol of belongs class. Zero belongs to A, but zero does not belong to B. Now, from here, I will start your exercise 1.2. Only some parts I will take so that you will not puzzle. So exercise 1.2, I will start here now. So class, as you can see, first question I have here of null set. Null set means empty set. Question is, now one more thing will come in your mind. In 11th class, chapter 1 is quite easy, right? Only we have to just find out which one is empty, which one is set, which one represents set, right? Now this is the starting of mathematics, right? In starting, generally we have some easy thing, right? So you have to practice all the parts of all the topics so that you can have the confidence. You can solve any type of question which is related to type, which is related to definition. Got it? So let's start here. First question, you can see we have here, which is based on null set, right? Question is about which of the following are examples of the null set. I have here first point, set of odd natural numbers divisible by 2. What? Set of odd natural numbers divisible by 2. It means first you should know what will come in your set. Odd natural numbers. What will come? Odd natural numbers. If I will talk about here odd natural numbers, so I have so many odd natural numbers. 1, 3, 5, 7, right? 11. Yeah, I have so many odd natural numbers. But last point is that should be divisible by 2. Right? That should be divisible by 2. Is it possible? Can we divide any odd natural number by 2? Just think about it. I will give you here some examples like 1, 3. Can you divide 1 by 2? Not possible. Can you divide 3 by 2? Not possible. So, odd numbers are what? Odd numbers, the definition of odd is what? All those numbers which cannot divide by 2 that we generally considered as an odd number. So this is against of definition of odd number, right? So class, this set will be what? Empty set, or we can say null set. Now let's talk about here set of bytes. Let's talk about here second part, set of even prime numbers. Set of even prime numbers. If you remember, in 10th class also in board exam, there was one question, right? In probability, you got one question, right? Which one? I think it was related to only even prime number. Maximum I have written 0 as an answer, right? But leave it. You should know prime number always start from 2. Prime number always start from 2, right? And even prime number, we have only one, which is 2. So in this set, we can have only single element, which will be class 2. So if in set we have single element, it will be singleton, not null set. So it's we can say second is a what? Second is not a null set. Now let's talk about your third part. X is a natural number and X is less than 5 and X is greater than 7. Right? X is less than 5. What? X is less than 5 and X is less than 7. Two condition I have. X 5 se chota hona chahiye aur X 7 se bada hona chahiye. It means class, I can write the value of X, which will be what? Less than 5. It means what? 4, 3, 2. Right. And X should be greater than 7. It's not possible. 4, 3, 2 are not greater than 7. 4, 3, 2 are less than 7. So class, this set will be what? This set will be empty set. Not possible. So it's what? It's empty set. Got it, class? So next, move towards our next part. Fourth part. In fourth part, class, you can see what I have here. Y, such that Y is a point common to any two parallel lines. Try to understand this statement. Y is a point common to any two parallel lines. Can we say, class, it's a null set? Yes, we can say it's a null set. Why? Because parallel lines never intersect, right? Not intersect, right? Parallel lines do not intersect. So we can say they don't have common point. If they don't have common point, it means we can say they, it's what? It's a null set. So this is all about my question number 1. So let's talk about your second part, class. I hope everything you are getting under the type of set. I will take here now only 2 parts of finite set, right? So question is, which of the following are finite or infinite? Which of the following sets are finite or infinite? Under this question, class, I will take here first part, the set of months of year. The set of months of year. Tell me one thing. In a year, we have total for 12 months. Can we count 12 months? Yes, of course we can count 12 months. January, February, March, April, all we can count. So this set will be finite. It has 12 elements. So, and remember one thing, question is about which one, right? Don't write only null or empty set. Write also reason why it's null set, okay? I'm just giving you a brief Excel description here, why it should be null set, infinite and finite set. As we can count all the months here, so what you have to write here, it has 12 elements, 12 months. So we can say it's what? It's a finite set. Let's talk about your second example. In second example, class, we have some elements 1, 2, 3 and you can see dot, dot. And it's very easy to understand about infinite. If dot, dot is going, it means what? These elements are going to infinite. Right, definitely it's by symbol only we can say it's infinite, no need to show anything. We can say we have here infinite number of natural numbers, right? Let's talk about the third part. Tell me one thing, in third part, can we say it's infinite? No, we have given here a boundation which is 100. We have given here boundation which is 100. Last element, I have here 100. In this set, I have listed numbers. I can count up to 100, right? So we can say it's a finite set. So class, this is all about my today's class. I hope you got it right from fourth part. I will take in next video. Okay. Do more and more practice of these set, these exam. Especially you have lots of time at home. Do one thing class. Do examples of your chapter one set theory.